Children, welcome back. Today we will be studying 7th science, 4th chapter, Nutrition in Living Organisms. Some life processes go on continuously in living organism. Substances which are digested and assimilated, that means taken, for obtaining energy and for the growth and health of our body are called foodstuffs. We get several types of nutrients from foodstuffs. Nutrients can be classified into two types, namely macronutrients and micronutrients. Nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, and fats are required in large quantity. These are macronutrients. Minerals and vitamins are required in very small quantities. They are called as micronutrients. The process of taking in and using food which takes place in living organism is called nutrition. Need for nutrition. First, to supply the energy required for doing work. Second, growth and development of the body. Third point, to replace the damaged cell and repair tissues. Fourth, to fight diseases. Autotrophic nutrition. Some organism can produce their own food and thus nutrition themselves. This is called autotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition. Some organism depends on other organism, plants or animals for their food are called as heterotrophic nutrition. Plant also need food for their growth. Children, how do plants produce their own food? They can produce their own food with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll, that is a green pigment which is present in the leaf. Plants make their food in their leaves using water and nutrient from the soil and carbon dioxide from the air. This process is called as a photosynthesis. The formula for photosynthesis is carbon dioxide plus water with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll. So you can see in the figure, the picture, it's given the formula. Food, that is glucose plus oxygen. And the molecular formula is given. 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives you food plus oxygen. Transport system of plants consists of the xylem and the phloem. The xylem transports minerals and water from the root to all aerial parts of the plant. The phloem transports the food, that is the glucose, from the leaves to the other parts of the plant where it is either consumed or stored. Though the plants have a transport system, they do not have a separate digestive or excretory system like us. Plants produce carbohydrates by the process of photosynthesis. Carbohydrates are made from carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Proteins are made from carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. Now, what do you think? How plants obtain the nitrogen necessary for the synthesis of proteins? Air contains gaseous nitrogen. However, plants cannot utilize gaseous nitrogen. It needs to be fixed, that is converted into compounds. Fixation of nitrogen occurs by biological atmospheric method. Now, biological fixation of nitrogen. Two different types of microorganism can bring about biological nitrogen fixation. Root nodules of leguminous plants contain the rhizobium microorganism. These microorganisms absorb atmospheric nitrogen and convert it into its nitrate, a compound. Microorganisms like Azotobacter are present in soil. They also convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrates. Symbiotic nutrition. In some cases, two or more than two different types of plants live together to fulfill their needs of nutrition, protection, support, etc. with each other's help. That means they are like their friends. They share their food and all. This type of nutrition is called symbiotic nutrition. Some fungi grow around the roots of some other plants. These plants supply nutrients to the fungi, and in turn, fungi supply mineral and water to the plants. Some fungi and algae live together. The fungi provide water, minerals, as well as shelter to algae. In return, the algae provide food to the fungi. So you can see in the picture, lichen is an example of a symbiosis between algae and fungi. Next is heterotrophic plants. Heterotrophic plants do not contain chlorophyll, and so they do not prepare their own food. Then, from where do they get food? The plants that grow on the body of other plants to obtain food are called as parasitic plants, for example, Loranthus and Cuscata. So you can see in the picture. Due to the absence of chlorophyll, the Cuscata is completely dependent on the host plant, hence it is said to be completely parasitic plant. So you can see in the picture. Next is insectivorous plants. We have seen how some plants feed upon insect to obtain nutrients. These insectivorous plants generally grow in soil or water deficient in nitrogen compound. See, these are the three examples of insectivorous plant: pitcher plant, Drosera, Venus flytraps. Now what happened? The scientist named Johns Burman identified this plant in Sri Lanka in 1737. And because of that, this plant was named as Drosera burmani. The plant body of the Drosera burmani has a flower-like appearance. It grows close to the ground. Its leaves are attractively pink or red in color. See, as you can see in the picture, they are very attractive with hairs at the margin. You can see in the margin a small droplet-like hairs. You can see that droplets of a sticky substance found at the tip of the hair attract the insect. And as the insect comes, they get immediately close and they eat that insect. Next is the saprophytic plants. Plants which obtain the food from dead and decaying bodies of other organisms are called saprophytic plants. Example is mushroom. You must have seen, especially in the rainy season, they grow near the wood and all. Various types of fungi like mushrooms and yeast are saprophytes. Fungi secrete digestive enzymes on the dead remains to digest or break down the carbon compound they contain. The resulting solution is absorbed to obtain nutrients in that saprophytic plants. Study types of nutrition in animals. Enteroic nutrition. Now, how does the unicellular amoeba inject food in the body? Amoeba does not have organ like hand and mouth. It is a unicellular animal. It can take in food through any part of the surface of its unicellular body. It surrounds the food particles from all sides to take it into the cell. After that, it digests the food with the help of different enzymes. Undigested food is left behind as the amoeba moves further with the help of the pseudopodia. In unicellular animals like amoeba, Euglena, Paramecium, etc., all the steps of nutrition occur within their unicellular body. Just observe in the picture. Insects have mouth part for injection of food, for example insects like cockroach and grasshopper, which nibble, have jaw-like mouth part. Butterflies suck food with the help of tube-like proboscis. Mosquitoes and bed bugs use a needle-like mouth part to pierce and a tube-like mouth part to suck blood or other fluids. The type of food, how animals can be classified. First is herbivorous. Herbivorous use plants directly as their food. Example are grazing animals. So you can see in the picture. Next is granivores. Granivores means seed eaters. And the next is frugivores, that is the fruit eaters. Next is carnivores animals. Animals that depends on other animals for their food are carnivores. Carnivores are indirectly depend on plants for food. Examples are animals that feed on herbivores, that is predators, so you can see in the picture, and animals that feed on insect are insectivorous. Next is omnivorous. Animals that obtain their food from both plants and animals are called omnivores. Examples are monkey, chimpanzees, humans, etc. Some of the organisms around us perform the functions of cleaning and conserving the environment by very act of feeding themselves. They are called as scavengers and decomposers. Scavengers obtain their food from dead bodies of animals, for example vultures, crow, hyena, etc. Decomposers are some microbes which obtain their food by decomposing the dead bodies of organisms or other materials. Nutrition. Some insects, unicellular animals, etc. obtain the nutrition by absorbing the liquid organic material from the dead bodies of other animals or from the environment. This is spirozoic nutrition. Example, housefly, ant, spider, etc. Parasitic nutrition. Have you seen small animals on the bodies of animals like dog and buffaloes? Which are those small animals? From where do these little animals obtain their food? From where do the worms in the intestine obtain their food? Listen now carefully. Some animals depend upon other animals for food. They can obtain the food only from animals on whom they are dependent. This is called as parasitic nutrition. Some animals live on the body surface of other animals and obtain their food by sucking their blood. This is called ectoparasitic nutrition, and such animals are called ectoparasite. For example, loose bed bugs, ticks, etc. Animals.
For your assignment, you will write the question answer from your science textbook, page number 33. The answers are given as follow in the video. You have to write this question answers in your science notebook.